in the honeycomb. There's sugar in the cane. There's oysters in a real oyster stew, and bubbles in sweet champagne.
Actress, singer, dancer, and civil rights activist, Lena Horne spent her extraordinary 50-year career dazzling audiences the world over with her powerful voice, graceful dance, and distinctively elegant style. From starring in musicals, including a Tony Award-winning Broadway show, to battling segregation during World War II and beyond, Horne's career was marked by both clear skies and stormy weather. Lena Mary Calhoun Horne was born in Brooklyn, New York on June 30, 1917. From an early age, she showed an interest in the arts, and at just 16 years old, Horne left Girls High School in Brooklyn to join the chorus at Harlem's Cotton Club, working as a dancer. At the time, the club required that blacks entertain exclusively white audiences. And although Horne wasn't allowed to sing, she was able to meet and observe musical artists of the era, including Duke Ellington, Cab Calloway, Count Basie, and Billie Holiday. Following her stint at the Cotton Club, Ms. Horne began singing with the Noble Sissles Society Orchestra. It was here that Horne developed the distinctive vocalizing style and sophisticated stage presence that she would later become known for. In 1940, she became the featured singer with Charlie Barnett's outfit, and as such, the first African-American to tour with an all-white band. When an MGM talent scout heard her sing at a New York nightclub, he arranged a screen test, which led to a contract with the studio in 1943. But Horne would soon experience barriers because of her race. After refusing to pass as Latina in such films as Panama Hattie and Duchess of Idaho, she was relegated to what she called window dressing performances, which were easily edited out of films. She went on to star in two musicals, Cabot in the Sky and Stormy Weather, which helped to elevate her to the status of one of the top nightclub and box office stars in the country. Throughout the 1950s, Horne worked primarily as a nightclub singer and made some of her most classic recordings. Ms. Horne used her powerful voice off the stage as well. From an early age, she committed herself to advocating for civil and human rights. She joined the NAACP in high school, and during World War II, refused to sing for segregated audiences or to groups which seated German POWs in front of African-American servicemen. She also worked with First Lady Eleanor Roosevelt to pass anti-lynching legislation, marched with civil rights leader Medgar Evers in Mississippi, and spoke and performed at the March on Washington in 1963. Ms. Horne continued to perform well into her 80s, and in 1981, won a Tony Award for her one-woman Broadway show, Lena Horne, The Lady and Her Music, which ran for 333 performances. Horne died on May 9, 2010, leaving behind an unforgettable legacy as both a stunning talent who paved the way for countless future generations of female singers, actresses, and performing artists, and as a fervent champion of civil rights. Standing on the shoulders of Lena Horne is 2013 DiPaysan Living Legacy Award winner, Felicia Rashad. Perhaps best known as one of America's favorite TV moms, Claire Huxtable, on the award-winning sitcom The Cosby Show, Ms. Rashad's rich and diverse acting career has included roles on the silver screen, on and off Broadway, television, and theaters worldwide. Born in Houston, Texas in 1948, Rashad grew up in a family of artists and educators. She attended Howard University, where she graduated magna cum laude in 1970 with a Bachelor's of Fine Arts degree. After leaving Howard, Ms. Rashad achieved success in a host of Broadway projects, including Dreamgirls, The Wiz, Into the Woods, and Jelly's Last Jam. Her other Broadway credits include the role of Violet Weston in August Osage County, Big Mama in Tennessee Williams' Cat on a Hot Tin Roof, Aunt Esther in August Wilson's Gem of the Ocean, and Queen Britannica in Shakespeare's Cymbeline at Lincoln Center. In 2004, Ms. Rashad became the first African-American woman to win the Tony Award for Best Actress in a Play for her riveting performance as Lena Younger in the Broadway revival of Lorraine Hansberry's A Raisin in the Sun. her directorial debut at the Seattle Repertory Theater with August Wilson's Gem of the Ocean was met with critical acclaim and rave reviews, which praised Rashad's ability to steer Seattle Rep's show with great sensitivity and understanding for both the text and actors. Like Lena Horne, Ms. Rashad has spent much of her time and energy offstage as an activist, supporting causes that are meaningful and uplifting to all people. She serves on the advisory board of the Prasad Project, a not-for-profit organization committed to improving the quality of life of economically disadvantaged people around the world, the board of directors of True Colors Theaters, the Broadway Inspirational Voices, the Actors Center, and the Center for African American Studies at Princeton University. She has also taught master classes at renowned educational institutions, including Howard University, Juilliard, and Carnegie Mellon. Ms. Rashad is the recipient of countless awards, including the Texas Medal of Arts, the National Council of Negro Women's Dorothy L. Height Dreammaker Award, AFTRA's Emmy Award for Excellence in Entertainment, multiple People's Choice Awards, and several NAACP Image Awards, among others. She also holds honorary doctorates from Spelman College, Fordham University, Carnegie Mellon, Howard University, Clark Atlanta University, and Brown University, among others. Just as Lena Horne left behind an indelible legacy through her stirring performances and power to move audiences, Ms. Rashad's art has brought and continues to bring joy, laughter, and reflection to audiences the world over, and has inspired the next generation of great actresses.